John, you go ahead.
Thank you, Sarah. Is the president really willing to go through another shutdown if he can't get any money out of the Democrats for the border wall?
The president doesn't want to go through another shutdown. That's not the goal. The goal is border security and protecting the American people. Ideally, Democrats would take these next 3 weeks to negotiate in good faith, as they've indicated that they would, and come up with a deal that makes sense, that actually fixes the problem, so we don't have to go through that process.
Well, what does he say to those like Republican Rob Portman and others who say that a shutdown should be taken off the table? In fact, to pass a law that basically says that shutdown can never be an option in the future. Would the president support that? Just take this off the table?
Look, I'm not going to get into the hypotheticals of taking that off the table. I haven't seen a piece of legislation for us to even consider at this point that would make that a reality. But what I do know is that the president is committed to fixing the problem. And it's pretty simple. We have 3 weeks to work with Democrats. As the president's indicated on a number of occasions, they could get this done in 15 minutes. We agree on the fundamentals that border security is important. We agree on the fact that there is a problem and we should do something about it. So let's spend some time over the next 3 weeks. Let's get it done. The president's opened the government on the basis that Democrats have signaled to us that they're willing to actually get serious about a real deal and get serious about fixing the problem at the border, including funding for a border wall.
Sure. Steve? Yeah. The president's proposals for the protecting the Dreamer children, some of the other concessions he made in his immigration speech, are those still on the table?
Look, I'm not going to negotiate here. That's why they have the conferences, for congressional members to work through some of those things, come back to the president with a deal. The president has laid out things in the past that he's willing to do. We'll see what they come back with. But what I do know is if they don't come back with a deal, that means Democrats get virtually nothing. That will make the president and force him to have to take executive action that does not give Democrats the things that they want. So this is a perfect time, and the table has been perfectly set by the president in order for a good deal to come together where everybody gets a little bit of something they're looking for. Josh?
The president has described illegal immigration, unchecked illegal immigration, as a perilous threat, and has said that they're taking American workers' jobs. Can you explain why the president hired and employed so many undocumented immigrants at his club for years and didn't do more to prevent them from staying employed and working there?
Look, I can't get into specifics about the president's organization outside of the White House. I'm only allowed to speak on behalf of the president in his official capacity. I do know that the Trump organization has put out a statement addressing that issue. I'd refer you to that and to them for further questions.
But, John, what does the president think, what does the president think should happen to a business that, you know, employs illegal immigrants and doesn't use systems to check and make sure that they're not doing that?
I think that's one of the reasons that the president wants to actually fix the problem. He's one of the people that's identified the fact that we have a problem and we should fix our immigration system. If Democrats want to get serious about fixing that, they have a president that's more than happy to sit down with them and do exactly that. John?
Since I know so little about this, let me ask you a couple of questions to see if I can educate myself.
At least we're in agreement on something.
Senator Joe Manchin. Senator Joe Manchin said yesterday that if the president were to move further on DACA and offer at least a path to status, if not a path to citizenship, he'd likely get more Democrats to come to his idea about the need for a border barrier. The president has been resistant to going any further than offering 3 years of more protections. What's the reason why the president doesn't believe that DACA recipients should have a path to status?
Again, I'm not going to negotiate up here. That's the reason that they're going into conference.
Why he doesn't believe that they deserve or should have a path to status?
Again, I'm not going to get into negotiating immigration reform up here. That's why we have the conference. That's why the president has asked that it take place over these 3 weeks. Whether or not that happens during this time or after, the focus of this right now is border security. We'd like to see that happen. And the president would love to deal with the overall problem of illegal immigration, fixing a number of the loopholes that would prevent some of those things from happening, so that we can move forward with a system that actually works and functions.
Sarah.
And congratulations. Welcome back.
Thank you.
You look more well-rested than you should, but go ahead.
What, is the White House going to have a representative in these meetings, the conference committee on the health?
I'm not aware of a specific White House attendee that would participate. Certainly, we'll be engaged with members across the board, both those that are part of the conference as well as the back and forth that will take place before and after.
What's data point here that...
But we'll keep you posted when White House is in attendance.
Okay. What's your data point here on the idea that Democrats are ready to, as you say, get serious about immigration reform? What is the signal that the president specifically got from Democrats?
We've had a number of Democrats that have both publicly stated support for border security, including a wall, including barriers. We've also had a lot of private conversations in which Democrats have signaled their willingness, if the government is open, to sit down and negotiate. The president is taking them at their word and hopes that they'll negotiate in good faith, and we hope that we'll see that happen.
Sarah.
Jordan?
Sarah.
Thanks, Sarah. Stephen Miller is quoted in a Cliff Samus book as saying, "I would be happy if not a single refugee foot ever again touched American soil." Is the policy of this administration to eventually get refugee resettlement down to zero?
I'm not aware of any statement like that Stephen Miller has ever made, and certainly not the policy of the administration.
Sarah, is the president going to have his physical exam soon?
The president will, as always, undergo a yearly physical exam. We'll keep you posted on the date and time when that happens.
Sarah.
April.
Sarah,
two questions. One, I want to go back to what Darlene asked, Mary Cudmull, and I'm going to ask in a different way. Can this economy sustain another...
Do you mind speaking up? I'm sorry.
I'm going back to what Darlene asked with Mr. Cudmull. Can this economy sustain with another government shutdown?
Again, as I told Jonathan, we don't want another government shutdown. We want a deal that actually addresses border security. It seems like it should be so simple. We're all in agreement that we need it. We're all in agreement that there's a problem, so let's fix it. So we don't have to go through that process again.
But can the economy, Larry Kudlow was very hopeful and optimistic, even though the numbers show otherwise?
Actually, the numbers don't show otherwise. The numbers show that we have an incredibly strong economy. The numbers show that jobs continue to grow, wages continue to rise, unemployment continues to drop. The numbers are actually very much in the favor of the things that Larry laid out. Again, do we want another shutdown? No, but the president and his team have focused on long-term economic stability, long-term economic fundamentals, and we think that if we had to, we could sustain that, but certainly we don't want to. That's not the goal.
So there are several people that are now indicted that have some kind of connection to either the campaign or the president. Have these people tried to make contact with the president via their mutual friends?
I'm not aware of any contact from those individuals.
Sarah.
John?
Sarah.
Thanks a lot, Sarah. On the State of the Union address, it was supposed to take place tomorrow night. I know that House Speaker Pelosi said that she would extend an invitation to the president once the government has reopened. It's reopened. Has she extended an invitation to the president? Do you believe, Sarah, that she's acting in good faith in this regard?
I certainly don't think she acted in good faith on the front end, considering she cited security concerns that didn't exist. But we're certainly hopeful that moving forward in the future that she will. The president, as he always does, looks forward to addressing the American people, and we'll do that as soon as that invitation is received. Francesca?
Sorry, go ahead. If I could, Sarah, do you expect her to extend an invitation to the president in the course of this 3-week window while negotiations are ongoing?
That's a better question for Speaker Pelosi.
Sarah.
Francesca.
Sarah. Thank you, Sarah. You're not exactly ruling out another shutdown, and many federal workers who came back today are concerned that there could be another shutdown. What's your advice or message to them in this 3 weeks? Should they be saving their money? Should they be concerned that they might not get another paycheck so soon?
My advice would be to call your Democrat members of Congress and ask them to fix the problem so that we don't have to continue having this process and so that we actually secure the border and protect American citizens.
Okay, Sarah. Steve. On the same subject, Sarah, the president tweeted over the weekend and said that he made no concessions whatsoever, but influential conservatives are saying that he has made concessions in this because he originally said that he would not sign any legislation that did not include money for the border wall. And then he went ahead and did that. And granted, it only keeps the government open for the next 3 weeks. He said he wouldn't do that either. And so how can the president say that he made absolutely no concessions to Democrats on this legislation?
Because the negotiations are still ongoing. And I would argue that conservatives that actually have influence have supported the president throughout this process. They believe in border security. They believe in protecting Americans, just like the president. And they stand with him. Again, this is a simple fix. It's easy for Democrats to sit down and come to an agreement and work with us to get border security. John?
Yeah. Thank you, Sarah. the president has spoken increasingly of declaring a state of emergency after February 15th and using funds already there for the building of the wall under the aegis of national security and homeland security. Several conservatives who are normally supporters of the president warned not to go in that direction, that it would create too many problems with federal authority interceding with state authority. President Bush in 2005 wouldn't declare a state of emergency over Katrina because he did not want to get into that argument with governors. Has the president considered this and the criticisms and warnings of fellow Republicans, notably Senator Blunt of Missouri?
Certainly the president listens to members of Congress as well as constituents across the country, but the president's number one duty and the number one responsibility he sees as commander-in-chief is protecting the American people. He sees the crisis at the border to be a real one. I don't think anybody in the country can argue the fact that there is a real problem at our border. It needs to be fixed, and the president's going to do what it takes to address it. Callie?
Thanks. I have a question for you on the shutdown, but first I want to ask, has the president ruled out a pardon for Roger Stone?
I'm not aware of that. Haven't had any conversations regarding that matter.
Will you discuss it with him and let us know?
I'm not going to get into that at this point, but if need be, we'll let you know.
You talked about the possibility that the president may use his executive authority. He has put that option on the table many times, most recently Friday in the Rose Garden. If the president truly believes that what's happening is an emergency, why would he wait 3 weeks to declare it?
Because it's real simple. As the president has said, as most of us in the administration have said on a number of fronts, the best fix is to be able to do it legislatively. But if Congress, particularly Democrats in Congress, would rather play political games and actually do their jobs and fix the problem, then the president will be forced to take a different path. Again, ideally that doesn't happen, but we'll see what happens.
Legally, it's either an emergency, Sarah, or it's not an emergency. You can't have a half emergency, right?
No, so which is you're missing the point. It is not just an emergency, it's a crisis at the border, both a national security and a humanitarian crisis. But there's a process in which the president wants to exhaust all options, primarily doing what we feel is the best one, which is a legislative fix. But if Congress doesn't do their job, then the president will be forced to make up for all of their shortcomings.
Major. Sarah, two questions, Sarah. You talked about what you're not going to negotiate. I'd like to ask you, is the $5.7 billion request from the president non-negotiable?
Again, I'm not going to negotiate from here. That's the whole point of the conference, is to iron out those details and come back to the president with a deal. At the end of the day, the biggest thing that has to happen is there has to be real and adequate funding for border security, including funding for a wall, and we'll see what the conference comes back with.
Would be a number of possibly less than 5.7.
Again, Major, I'm not going to negotiate with you. That's not my role. My job is to communicate where we are in the process, and right now we're in the process of letting the conference do its job, negotiate a deal, and come back to the president.
Thank you, Sarah. Two questions for you, if I may. First, on the government shutdown, the president made several promises to families, particularly those who have been affected by crimes committed by illegal immigrants, that they would have a wall at the end of this government shutdown, at the end of this promise. Can he maintain that promise that there will be, to those families, that there will be a wall on the southern border by the end of his first term?
As you know, the president and his administration have engaged and built contracted to build roughly 115 miles of the border. This three-week package that just passed that Democrats actually voted for included over $200 million in funding for the wall. And the president's not going to stop until the border is secure, and that includes having a border wall.
Another question for you on Afghanistan. There's talk in Afghanistan by the U.S. envoy of a deal that would basically pull U.S. forces out of the country in exchange for a guarantee from the Taliban that there will be no terrorists who remain in the country. Is that a plan that has the White House's support? Is the president's support that sort of plan, and would that be a victory for the United States after almost 17 years of war there?
Our priority is to end the war in Afghanistan and to ensure that there is never a base for terrorism in Afghanistan again. Negotiations are going to continue. For anything specific, I can't get into that right now, but I refer you to the State Department beyond that.
Sarah, thank you. Just to follow up quickly on your answer to Hallie, you said, "I'm not aware of that," when asked if the president had ruled out a pardon for Roger Stone. So does that mean he hasn't ruled out a pardon?
Again, I'm not aware of any conversation even regarding that or a need for it.
Can you guarantee, Sarah, just to follow up, can you guarantee that the president won't pardon Roger Stone?
Again, I'm not going to talk about hypotheticals that are just ridiculous of things I haven't talked about. Never thought I would be shutting down one reporter to go to Jim Acosta, but here we are.
Rubio said over the weekend, Sarah, that working with WikiLeaks should be considered a crime. Does the president agree?
I'm sorry, I didn't hear the last part.
Marco Rubio said over the weekend that working with WikiLeaks should be considered a crime. Does the president agree?
Look, I think every single outlet that you all represent looked for and searched for information that WikiLeaks was providing, including reporting on it. So I think there's a responsibility by members of the media. I'm not aware of anybody here ever working with WikiLeaks in any capacity, but I do know that every individual that represents a media organization here looked for that information. Most of you reported on that information. So I think you're just as accountable as anybody else in that process. Jim, go ahead.
If I can jump in. Roger Stone last week, Paul Manafort, Michael Cohen, Michael Flynn. Are you concerned, is the president concerned, that as more and more of his associates, former aides, are brought into this investigation, are indicted, plead guilty in this investigation, that this presidency is in danger?
Not at all. In fact, I think nothing could be further from the truth. The more that this goes on, the more and more we see that none of these things have anything to do with the president. In Roger Stone's case, the charges of that indictment have literally nothing to do with the president and have to do with his communications with Congress. So, in fact, I think the further we get into the process, the more and more we see that this has nothing to do with President Trump.
Can I follow up on that?
Sure.
If I may. And can you assure the American people that during these conversations that Roger Stone had with WikiLeaks and individuals who were tied to the dumping of that material, that at no time the president had any interactions with Roger Stone, that nobody close to the president had interactions with Roger Stone who may have told the president what was going on in those conversations? All of this, when it comes to Roger Stone, is a complete surprise to the president? He didn't know about any of this? Is that what you're saying?
What I can tell you is that the president did nothing wrong throughout this process, and the charges of the indictment against Mr. Stone have absolutely nothing to do with the president.
Sarah.
Take one last question, Steve.
Yes, Sarah. We're expecting in a few moments that the U.S. government will announce some criminal actions against Huawei, the Chinese telecom company. And we're just about to have this Chinese trade delegation here. Are these two at all linked? Are you taking some sort of carrot and stick approach with China? What's the strategy here?
No, those two things are not linked. They're a totally separate process. The negotiations on the trade front will continue to be ongoing. And I believe on that other question and thing that you mentioned may be coming, I believe they're waiting on me to finish so that they can do that. So with that, I will say good afternoon. We'll see you next time. Thanks, guys.
Thank you.